morning students. I hope you all are doing well. So we'll continue our revision of chapter 8, the last two topics. Today we will revise, and these topics are Ashoka's place in history and his administration. So let's get started.
So children, till now we have done the Mauryan administration, then the Ashoka's main principles of Dharma, after that the importance of edicts and inscriptions, then Kalinga War, till here we have done. So today we are going to revise the next topic, new topic, that is the Ashoka's place in history. Children, after Bindusara, his son Ashoka ruled for 273 to 232 BC, and he was the most famous Mauryan king and one of the greatest rulers ever. So our today's topic is the Ashoka's place in history. Why its place in history is very important. He is regarded as one of the greatest rulers of India, like the Alexander. He was a great conqueror, but gave up fighting for a cause also. Ashoka raised Buddhism from a local sect to a world religion. Ashoka followed the policy of religious tolerance. Even not only this, children, Ashoka gave the best administration to his people. He treated his people like his own children. He always ready for the welfare of the people. And even he opened the hospitals also for men and the animals also. In fact, there was all round development during Ashoka's reign. That's why its place in history is very important. It's a very important place in history, Ashoka's place. So the main points we'll revise once again. First is, he was the greatest ruler of India. Second, he raised Buddhism. Third, the policy of religious tolerance. Fourth, there was all-round development. Fifth, he gave the best administration to his people. So this is the topic, Ashoka's place in history. So our next topic is the Ashoka's administration. Children, before Ashoka's administration, we'll talk about his grandfather's administration also. His grandfather was the Chandragupta Maurya, and even Ashoka's father's administration also, his father was Bindusara. So if we'll talk about Chandragupta Maurya's administration, so he was very strict about his administration, and he always more emphasis on expansion of empire. Means Chandragupta Maurya, the grandfather of Ashoka, he stressed on strict administrative work. Second, the Bindusara, the father of King Ashoka, he maintained the diplomatic relations with the Greek kings. He always emphasized on the relations with Greek kings only, diplomatic relations. Now we'll talk about our topic, Ashoka's administration. So Ashoka laid great stress on welfare of the people. He always think about their welfare of the people. He laid more emphasis on welfare of the people. He built many roads and planted trees on both the sides of the roads. He built rest houses for the travelers. He had wells dug for the people. He opened a large number of hospitals. both for people also and for the animals also. And he treated his people as his own children. All the times he was ready for the service of his people. So, the main points are Ashoka's stress on people's welfare. He built many roads and rest houses for the people. He opened large number of hospitals for the people and for the animals also. He treated his people as his own children. So this is the second topic, Ashoka's administration. Now today's work, one word answers. Founder of Mauryan Empire, Chandragupta Maurya. Chandragupta Maurya defeated the Greek general Seleucus. Ashoka's religion was based on a set of moral principles. Ashoka appointed new officers called Dhamma Mahamantras. Last is, Ashoka's royal codes were called edicts. And question number 2 also you will get in the PDF file. Estimate Ashoka's place in history. In this question, you will write the 5 points. First, greatest rulers of India. Second, raised Buddhism. Third, policy of religious tolerance. Fourth, all-round development. And fifth is best administration. So these 2 questions you will do in the homework, and these 2 you will get in the PDF file also. So today we have revised the 2 topics, Ashoka's place in history, and second is Ashoka's administration. In Ashoka's administration, we have revised the 4 points, great stress on people's welfare, build many roads and rest houses, opened large number of hospitals, treated his people as his own children. And in the homework, you will do the one word questions also, and along with the one more question, Ashoka's place in history. So that's all for today, children. Be happy, stay fit. Bye-bye.